All right, welcome back. Please don't mind the cats. They are not going to let me work in peace. So you're going to have them on the camera today. Hope you're okay with that. Next thing we're going to cover today in this lesson is the rhythm of a two-step. So I covered the footwork. It's quick, quick, slow, slow, or one and two, three is how you'd count that. And we're going to do that to traditionally eight count music. Okay, so that's really most music. So that's top 40s, most country songs, most music today, especially in the United States and Europe, is an eight count style of music, which means you can do a two-step to it. We just need to know how to time our steps with the song. So we're going to talk about that in this video. And one more side note, there is one kind of song we won't be able to do a two-step to, and that is a waltz, okay? A waltz has a whole different measure. It sounds more like one, two, three, one, two, three in the song. You'll be able to hear that after a while. And that's the one you don't want to do a two-step to. You're going to have to do a waltz to that music, okay? Otherwise, I'm just going to play a couple of country songs. My preference is country. You can do this, like I said, to top 40s if you really wanted to. Traditionally, it's done to country music. I'm just going to play a couple, and I'm going to dance and do the footwork to that rhythm so that you can copy along and do it, you know, from the comfort of your own house as well. At this stage, I wouldn't recommend doing it with your partner yet. We'll talk more about how to hold your partner and work with your partner around the dance floor in the next lesson. But for this one, just, you know, do it in place. If you and your partner are both watching this, maybe stand side by side. And you, one of you do the leader's footwork, one of you do the follower's footwork. And then we'll put it together in the next lesson, okay? So just watch on for two-step to different songs. And feel free, I'm gonna create a playlist on Spotify that I will share with you in the notes here. Feel free to go download that playlist or go, you know, subscribe to it. And I'll have a video of myself dancing to the beat of all those songs so you can watch what I do, mimic that, and you'll have a good understanding of how to match that. Okay, so let's get started. Alexa, play Whiskey Glasses by Morgan Wallen.
Whiskey Glasses by Morgan Wallen from Spotify.
Pour me another drink. 'Cause I don't
remember, it's quick, quick, slow, slow. And remember that leaders are going to kick it off with your left leg and followers with your right leg. Okay, here we go. Five, six. Five, six, seven, eight. Quick, quick, slow, slow. Quick, quick, slow, slow. Slow, slow. Quick, quick, slow, slow. Quick, quick, slow, slow. Quick, quick, slow, slow. Alexa, stop. Okay, so what you just saw there, and hopefully you were able to do it along with me. If you're not, I mean, you're missing out on some muscle memory opportunities there. But regardless, what you just saw was me doing the two-step footwork, quick, quick, slow, slow, and timing that to the song Whiskey Glasses by Morgan Wallen, which is a very popular, you know, top 40s country song. Most people have heard it. And what I did there was I was bouncing my, to hear for it, I was bouncing my right leg, to the downbeat. Once I found that downbeat, I just kicked it off counting to eight. One, two, three. Once I got to eight, I was able to get started. And so I just kind of felt the quick, quick, slow, slow. And again, it's the slows are half as fast as the quicks. Okay, so again, if I'm counting that, it's one and two, three. One and two, three. Okay, and you count that obviously up to eight and start over. Most people don't count that way because it doesn't divide into eight very well, which is why most people go with the quick, quick, slow, slow. But there you have it. That's a lot of extra information for you. Go ahead and practice that. Subscribe to the playlist that I created in Spotify that's in the notes there for this lesson. And, you know, watch the companion video of me just dancing in place to the song so that you can, you know, mimic what I'm doing. And after a while, you'll start to feel what's happening to your body, which will help you hear it in all music. Okay, that's how I did it. That's a good way to get started. So there you have it. We'll see you in the next lesson as well, where we'll talk about how to actually hold your partner. Okay, thanks.